this morning. So let's get you started. And heavy rain has been part of the thunderstorm story across the country. This is no different. We have a flash flood watch posted for most of Oklahoma, includes Oklahoma City, just outside of Tulsa as well. We still are tracking some of those thunderstorms now pushing into southwestern Missouri as well, triggering some flash flood warnings, as you can see right there, south of Springfield. But there's the sort of diving down of all of the showers and the thunderstorms well south of Oklahoma City, so getting a nice little break. But you see a lot of lightning and you're hearing the thunder this morning too, so they're still going. I want to just point out this in Cherokee, Jasper, and Newton counties, the flash flood warning out until 11:45 Central Time. Just watch for the high water on the roadways. This could be a really messy start to the day, and if it's the kickoff of your long weekend, it's going to be a stormy start as well. South of St. Louis as well, heading into that I-57 corridor. Some heavy rain moving off to the east. This is all part of what was developing yesterday and brought about the severe weather. So that is sort of the leftovers. Timing that out, you'll see that will continue to move on out, dissipate a little bit. We get into the afternoon and evening and you see showers and thunderstorms firing up from New Mexico to Colorado and then really get going again as we get into tomorrow afternoon. So a couple of rounds here that could bring showers and thunderstorms, not to mention the heavy rain and the hail, which we've seen already in the last 24 hours. There you go. By Sunday morning, the model coming out again over Oklahoma City, which is why it's not just a flash flood watch that you have to be concerned about today, really, as we get into the later half of the weekend. And there's a real telling sign that flooding could be an issue. Rainfall forecast through Tuesday. Again, that is a longer time period, but you get the picture. That area in yellow is basically seeing storms over the same area over a couple days. So heads up. The south, other parts of the get you ready for the rest of the Friday and kicking off the weekend. So we're going to start off, like we have many weekends in this region, with the chance for showers and thunderstorms. And looking at the rainfall total here through Sunday morning, you see a few pockets where we could end up with as much as 1 to 2 inches of rainfall. This is a sign that thunderstorms will absolutely be part of it, and maybe ones that will kind of hang out for a minute and dump a lot of rain. The setup is there, right? We've got this jet stream, the train track for our disturbances to roll along, and we have the surface features as well. The area of low pressure, the cold front, all ways to lift the air and produce thunderstorms. And if you've been outside, you probably have noticed a little uptick in some of that humidity, that moisture. But that cold front's going to move slowly off to the east here as we get in through tomorrow. So that kind of keeps this region in a little bit of that unsettled pocket of the atmosphere. Just a few spotty showers out there right now. We think probably on the increase later tonight and early tomorrow for a lot of folks here. So today, basically from Cincinnati to Roanoke up towards Syracuse and State College, as well as Allentown, you could be looking at some thunderstorms as early as today. And then most of the rest of the region catching up tonight. And that means if you're heading down the shore, the AC Expressway, you've got showers along the way, crossing the Bay Bridge, that's going to be a stormy ride potentially. And even on up into New England by tomorrow, more showers and thunderstorms. The good news is a lot of this will be out in time for Sunday. So salvaging part of the weekend. And Buffalo, just sit tight Friday night and Saturday is your storm. Even heavy rain to the possibility of some hail. Right now, fairly quiet across the region, including in Green Bay, Minneapolis, and Marquette. Cloudy skies right now. See the next few hours, that area of low pressure and that cold front. There you go, Indianapolis. Could be triggering some of those thunderstorms as we get to Dayton and Columbus as well, trying to make their way into Cleveland by later today. And then tomorrow, much improved. You've got a beautiful day. Chicago, St. Louis, 84, a nice summer afternoon. Those showers and thunderstorms off into the plains here on Saturday, by Sunday, moving back in towards Minneapolis. But we sit tight, hold on to a decent weekend here from Detroit, Chicago, Cincinnati, basically most of Oklahoma right now. This is through today. You can see Tulsa technically out of it. A lot of the heaviest rain that we're seeing has moved way to the south, but definitely for good reason. It is still there. Oklahoma City, Woodward, you are in that watch area, which means you have had a lot of rain and any little bit could add to that problem. So here's what we were tracking. This whole system was moving down to the south. It woke you up probably in Oklahoma City early this morning, and we now see some of those showers draped across the Red River Valley, and you have off towards Springfield and the Joplin area. some of the flash flood warnings out there right now. That means flash flooding is happening or imminent. So take this seriously. Give yourself plenty of extra time if you're hitting the roadways in this area. But in effect for Cherokee, Jasper, and Newton counties until 11:45 Central Time. So here we go across the next couple of hours, and you see a little bit of the drying. Some of those storms get pushed off to the south and east. We get a little bit of a reprieve in this area, but we see it pick back up by tomorrow afternoon, especially Wichita, Amarillo, the panhandle of Oklahoma. That even continues overnight Saturday and into early on Sunday. So once again, Oklahoma City talking about some early heavy rainfall by the time Saturday night into Sunday rolls around. No surprise. Here we go again, right? The numbers really tell the story, though, I think. From Atlanta to Birmingham, Jackson, and Montgomery, looking at the rainfall total since June 1st, but to get a kind of a grasp of what that number really means, look at the departure from average. And you see Birmingham and Montgomery over a foot. This is just for the summer, just since June 1st. So really, really incredible. And then especially incredible to see perhaps another 1 to 2 inches of rainfall blanketed across the region. Also notice too, Eastern North Carolina. You saw that 3 to 5 inches of rainfall. So we're keeping an eye on you as well. Looking at the water vapor imagery, you see a lot of gray, but what you don't see is a lot of the orange. This is where you're signaling the drier air. None of it. None of it's getting really down here. Not at the surface, not at the mid-levels either. So anything that develops, you even see this morning, slow kind of moving, drifting showers and thunderstorms, nothing that's coming in and tearing out. And you get a couple to kind of sit there, and that's how you get that rain to add up really, really quickly. And we are seeing a little bit of that here in eastern North Carolina. If you look at the clock, just over the last hour, not really moving out of that area. We don't yet have any warnings associated with those showers, but we will keep an eye on it because they could be looking at perhaps 3 to 4 or 5 inches of rainfall. Greenville, you're kind of right in that zone, so watch out there. Also in towards Montgomery, you saw how much rain you've gotten so far. Add another inch or so by the time Tuesday rolls around, and yes, you've got yourself a soaker. We have storm